Morning. Praise God. I'm going to try and convey a little message. It sounded way better in my head. So please bear with me. The Lord gave and the Lord has taken away. Job 1, verse 21. I heard that yesterday in a TV show. You know, and it got me thinking, some people have this idea that, yeah, God's going to provide for us, but whenever he feels like it, he's going to take it away. It doesn't work that way. So after I saw that, it got me thinking about shepherds and sheep. And the Bible says that the Lord is our shepherd. Psalm 23, verse 1. You know, he's always watching over us, taking care of us, providing for our every need. But one thing that we have to remember is that when we stray, it says in Matthew 18 that the shepherd goes after the one sheep out of the hundred that goes astray. And when he finds that sheep, he rejoices. He still loves the other 99,
sure.
But the other 99 are saved, you know? So let's give the one that's lost so doesn't die or anything. So I started thinking, you know, we're also shepherds. And the things that we receive from the Lord, those are our sheep. And if he gives us something and we lose it, it's because we did not follow his word. He didn't take it away.
Right.
The enemy is lurking around trying to take away from us what the Lord has given us. So if we lost something, it's because we unfortunately allowed him to operate in our life in some way. But we know how to bring those things back. And the way we do that is by following the word of God. You know, he shows us how to bring those sheep back to our flock. So I've been thinking also lately about his people returning to him. James chapter 4 says, draw near to God and he will draw near to you. And then I also got this scripture from Hosea chapter 6 that says, come, let us return to the Lord, for he has torn us that he may heal us. He has struck us down and he will bind us up. After 2 days, he will revive us. On the third day, he will raise us up that we may live before him. Let us know, let us press on to know the Lord. He's going out as sure as the dawn. He will come to us as the showers, as the spring rains that water the earth. So after I read the scripture, I try to tie this to the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus. He didn't leave anything undone when he came. And the moment that he said, when he was nailed to the cross, it is finished, everything that God set him to do here on earth was completed. Mm-hmm. And when he resurrected, that's the moment that every person living at that moment, and now to this very day, that were not even thought of at that time, that's when they all started to come and be drawn near to the Lord through him. And that's the thing that was sounding better in my head than I just said it. So, you know, let us just come to him. He's going to bring us up. He's going to take care of us.
Yes.
Trusting him, you know, every time, whatever happens. And, you know, when we, let's just come to him so we know and learn how we can bring back the lost sheep from our lives. So, That's it. Still need to find a way with words, but anyway. Anyone has any testimony or prayer request? Mike? Isn't today her birthday?
It is her birthday. It's definitely her birthday. She's going to be a year older today. That's a wise man.
Yeah. Scoring brownie points. Good. Anyone else?
Miss Di. Keep me in your guys' prayers. I've just been in kind of a funk these last couple weeks.
Now that you say that, this scripture has been in the atmosphere for a while, and we're actually working on putting something, writing a song actually about it. So I want to read it to you because it just came to mind as soon as you said that. This is from Ezekiel 34. It says, "For thus says the Lord God, behold, I myself will search for my sheep, and I will seek them out. As a shepherd seeks out his flock when he is among his sheep that have been scattered, so will I seek out my sheep, and I will rescue them from all places where they have been scattered on a day of clouds and thick darkness. And I will bring them out from the peoples and gather them from the countries, and will bring them into their own land. And I will feed them on the mountains of Israel, by the ravines, and in all the inhabited places of the country. I will feed them with good pasture, and on the mountain heights of Israel shall be their grazing land. There they shall lie down in good grazing land, and on rich pasture they shall feed on the mountains of Israel. I myself will be the shepherd of my sheep, and I myself will make them lie down, declares the Lord God. I will seek the lost, and I will bring back the strayed, and I will bind up the injured, and I will strengthen the weak, and the fat and the strong I will destroy. I will feed them in justice. Don't worry, because you're coming to the good land." So, stay there.
Yes. I just want to share, kind of, I don't know what it is, a testimony or I don't know. It's been on my heart, and the Lord doesn't leave you. He doesn't forsake you. He's with you always. It doesn't matter. Are you going to go to hell if you don't come to church or not come to church? No, that's not it at all. But it's so important every time that we gather together because, you know, just like you get up every morning, you have breakfast, lunch, and supper. This is where we get fed. And I'm telling you, This is like the best of the best, what we're getting. And we need to maybe awaken to the fact, you know, we're used to it every day. You get used to it every day because this is the food that we eat all the time. There's a lot of people out there that aren't getting crumbs like this. Yeah. And so we need to speak his word. We need to share what we're getting because it's phenomenal. And it's just been burdening my heart that we come here and sometimes take things for granted because we are blessed. But the food that we're getting, I thank God because it keeps me going every day and it keeps me growing. And, you know, you got to have the manna to survive. We need to come together and encourage each other because the evil out there, I mean, it's evil and it gets crappier every day.
Sounds good. Tally.
Can I speak out too? All morning, all I've been thinking about is we need to declare in our prayers, each and every one of us, the favor of God upon Abundant Life Community.
Yes.
So we need our Moritas that drive by and God speak to them. And
yes.
Say, I need to yes. That church.
Yes.
There's a reason for us being here, but this is not acceptable. These
no.
Empty pews.
Yeah.
This is not acceptable. This is not what God wants. So
no.
We need to declare the favor of God upon
yes.
This church.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Mike.
We had a guest Friday night who is part of a large movement. They're not gigantic, but they're large. He came Friday night and several times through the house prayer last Friday night. He wept. The only thing I'm going to say is at the end of the time, I talked to him, and he said, the venue that you're going to, which will put announcements here pretty quick, he says, you need to bring what you just did here last Friday night to show other people this is where God is at, this is what God wants to do. And what I've seen in the midst of it, and we recorded it, even in the midst of it, the worship team were bringing forth revelation, the grace revelation. The message was going out through the song, the prophetic song and the song. Whatever it takes to get this out, I feel that, yes, this place needs to hear and be full. And whatever it takes to get this done, the Holy Ghost, however he directs each of us to have that happen. I believe this is like a crack in the wall of what's been holding things back here. And I believe that this is a situation where we're going out to the end of the camp and stealing back what God's heart really wants and desires. And we will see a good fruit very, very shortly.
Praise the Lord.
It's coming. Anyone else? Mark.
It's not received, it's not accepted. And that's the way of this world.
it wants to push the truth out. You see all the different religions that are spewing forth whatever it is that they're spewing, but again, God doesn't care about your religion. He cares about you, your relationship with Him, and knowing what the truth is. And, you know, it is important to be here. And I used to think it was more, you know, it was more so, well, I gotta go to church because, you know, I have to be there. Well, why? What is the importance to it? It is to get fed. Mm-hmm. It's very important that we get fed. Nourishing meals, which yes. we do. Mm-hmm. But it's also important from a standpoint of each other. Mm-hmm. Because with each other, but I mean, when we're here, we're in the house of God. The expectation is we're going to hear about God. Mm-hmm. Well, the expectation needs to be out there so that I'm not worried about what Joe or Sally or Frank thinks about my stance with the truth, because everybody needs to hear it. What they do with it is what they do with it. We're all doing what we're doing with the truth right now. Amen. We're either receiving it or we're rejecting it, one of the two. Mm-hmm. So it's... the norm of what takes place here needs to be the norm that's what takes place out there.
Amen.
And we are all shepherds. Amen?
Amen.
We all can be shepherds. And to aspire to do that and to go after the lost, because they're everywhere. And to hear this beautiful truth is just, I mean, it's precious. And I am thankful. But, just continue to lift one another up for strength, wisdom, power. That's already there. It's finished.
Yeah.
I can be just like Jesus and walk the streets and proclaim his truth. But the proclamation of that is, it's just awesome. I'm thankful.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Amen.
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 Anyone else?
I just want to read something. I was going to read this Friday night. I didn't want to interrupt, but the Lord brought it to my mind, and I was looking it up, and I thought, well, it was a flow, and sometimes as a pastor, I don't want to just inject myself into it, because when everybody else is moving, that's a good thing. And I'm afraid sometimes if I do that, then everybody thinks, well, we got to have, he has to say something. That's not the case, but I got home and I looked it up again, and this morning I came back and went home again. And I think it's in 2 Samuel chapter 5 where the Philistines found out that David had been anointed. And if we use the metaphor, put this into a context where we understand that's us.
Mm-hmm.
We've been anointed of God. We are kings and priests. And the enemy immediately comes against that to try to either destroy that in you or that reality to others.
Mm-hmm.
And so he comes to destroy him, and David goes out and they battle and defeat the enemy in this battle at Rephaim. But then down in verse 23, the Philistines gather again. Because the devil, just because he's defeated, he doesn't get up. He keeps coming back. Trying to inject things into your thoughts, into your mind, into your circumstances. And so David, he did a wise thing. Instead of doing like they had done back in the time of Joshua, where they went out, God told them to do something, they did it, then another situation arises, and they try to repeat what they had just done, thinking that, well, that's what God wanted me to do there, so certainly it must be what he wants me to do now. And the reason I'm saying this is because the things we're talking about here is to be led by the Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
What Sally said, people are here. I believe this. I believe they're here because they were led by the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
To be here, not because, our advertising. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm just saying that's not why people are here.
Right.
So David comes back before the Lord, and he inquires of the Lord. He says, shall we again go out and attack him like we did last time? And here's what the Holy Spirit says. Thou shalt not go up, but fetch a compass behind them and come upon them over against the mulberry trees. I got that word up when I got home. And that word for mulberry tree is actually baca. And it's the same thing. I preached a message years ago about the Valley of Baca, the place of tears, and how a great victory came out of that. What looked to be a total loss, what looked like it was going to be failure and destruction, turns out to be a great victory.
Hallelujah.
And so that's what the Lord told him. He said, don't go out and attack him. Come around from behind. Be subtle about this. And wait on Spirit, because the next thing that he says, when you hear the sound of the wind and those trees, you'll know I'm meeting you and I'm going to go before you and defeat them. So what we're trying to do here is not to build a mega church, I'm not saying we shouldn't go out and invite people to church. Don't misunderstand what I'm saying. But what I'm saying is we want this to be led by the Spirit.
Exactly. It
doesn't do us any good to just listen. We've had numbers here when we first got the building, we moved, and it was full of people with all sorts of differing kind of ideas about what this was going to be and what they expected me to do and how they expected me to do it. I tried to be faithful to the Lord, and to the best of my ability, I'm not saying I'm perfect about that. But I want this to be a Holy Ghost thing.
Yes. Yes.
Exactly. A thing of God.
Amen.
And so all I'm saying is that let's be led by the Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
That's what we're trying to do. Mm-hmm. We've tried to do that in every way, whether it's worship, whether it's through the different types of ministry. And that's the only thing that works.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
You know, we can go out in our own strength and have some success. But we want something that's going to be eternal. We want something that's going to have lasting mm-hmm. impact. And something that people cannot question.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
You know, I talked about it last week, and different times I talked about, you know, people being slain in the Spirit. Listen, I'm not against any of that. I know sometimes I'm misunderstood and I'm anti-manifestation. That's not true. I just want it to be God. I don't want it to be me. I don't want it to be us.
Right.
So I'm willing to trust that in an environment where God is lifted up and God is the focus, God will move.
Amen.
And people will have healings and people will experience them. But I think sometimes we have to unteach the religious kind of ways that we've done things, thinking that we can just go back and do it again because we had some success the last time. God wants us to be led by His Spirit.
Exactly.
He wants us to come to Him and say, okay, God, how do you want to do this?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, what do you want to do? We're unique. Every body, every individual body of Christ is unique. Therefore, every collective body is unique.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we all have the same purpose, but we're not all the same. And so this group, this body of believers, if God wants to do something, I believe, genuinely, I believe He wants to do something unique.
Amen.
He's taken
Amen.
What He said He would do. The nobodies. I didn't go to Bible college. I don't have a degree in theology. I was a guy selling axles and hubs and drums to people that were building oil rigs when God called me.
Mm-hmm.
I never went to Bible college. I never went, you know. In fact, my early training was a lot of it was wrong. Mm-hmm. It just wasn't that. But God takes the things that are not to bring to not the things that are. He takes the things that don't look that great to the natural mind and to the world and uses them
yes.
for His glory.
Yes.
He takes the nobodies and makes something out of it. Not for our glory, but for His glory. Mm-hmm. So that people look at it and they can't deny that was God. Believe me, the people that know me most of my life, it freaks them out.
Uh-huh.
I see it at, you know, different places, fearlessly, and, you know, they're dumbfounded. They're thinking, this is the last guy in the world
yeah.
that I would have ever imagined to be a preacher. You know? So, that's what God does. He takes the insignificant, the nobodies, the nothings, the, you know, the underachievers, whatever you want to call it, and shows Himself by it. That's what I want for this church. I want for this church the same thing that I experienced. This is still a weird thing for me. I mean, I think Sunday mornings a lot of times I go, I think, are you really going to go down there and do this again? I mean, it's not my nature to be a religious, you know,
mm-hmm.
a preacher. This is something that God does.
Yeah.
And I'm saying that's what I want everybody to experience what I've experienced. The reason I keep doing it, because I know it was God.
Mm-hmm.
Not because of how many people show up, because I'm as bummed out and, you know, aggravated about that as anybody is, but I just don't make a big deal out of it. But I continue to do this for 25, 30 years
uh-huh.
because I know that it was God.
Yes.
And He didn't tell me, you're going to do this if you get 10,000 people in a building.
No.
He just told me you're going to do this.
Yeah.
Here you go.
And if I'm faithful, He'll be faithful to me. And that's true for every one of us. So I want everybody to experience the supernatural aspects of God.
Yes.
To know that when they have this encounter, when they have this call, this whatever it is for each one of us, they know that it's God. Then you don't back off. Then you don't throw up your hands and give up. I mean, there'll be skids, believe me. There'll be times when you want to just bail. But something will always keep you in the call that God has for your life.
Yes.
If it's God. We want it to be God. I want it to be God for every person that comes into this church. I want them to experience what I've experienced. I want it to be as real to them as it is to me.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Thank God. I know that he's somebody.
Yes.
That's it. We need it. We need to wait. I'm not saying we don't need to do anything. I'm saying we need to wait on the Lord. We need to wait for that sound, that breeze, that wind of the Holy Spirit to lead us and guide us. And when we do, we're always victorious. We'll always be victorious when we go to God first, when we inquire of him. And that's what we're doing. That's what we're trying to do. We're declaring. We're doing what God has told us to do. And we're waiting. Just like Mike said. Every one of us, and Terry, we prophesy. That's what we are to do. We're prophesying all the time, whether we know it or not. So let's make sure that the prophecies that we're speaking are in agreement with what God says.
Come on.
Let's throw our hands up in the air and just say, well, what's the point? You know? There's only 10 people here. You know? Numbers mean nothing to God. God can give the increase. He is the only one that really can increase.
Amen.
That's right. So I hear a sound in the moment.
Yes.
That's what I'm saying.
Amen.
I don't see the enemy laying dead before us, but I know they're as good as dead because if I can hear that sound, if I can hear the Holy Spirit, I don't care what the voice of God is saying. Whatever he's saying, it's done. Mm-hmm. And he's already told us, enlarge the place of your tent.
Mm-hmm.
You know? The children of the desolate are greater than those of the married wife. God told me that 30 years ago, before I knew Isaiah 54 existed.
Right.
Amen.
In the bedroom of a little house in Vidor, Texas. Pregnant. And that's a fact. I didn't know the Bible. I didn't know there was an Isaiah, let alone an Isaiah 54. But the Lord quoted that very chapter to me in prayer.
Amen.
And that's why I'm still here.
Amen.
As he said it, he's going to do it.
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
And he wants to do the same thing for all of us. He wants to increase our influence, each one of us, in every area. And everything you set your hand to should prosper.
Yes.
That's what God said. That's your promise.
Yes.
Yes.
Faith takes it without having any evidence. That's
exactly
what faith is. It's the substance of what it is we're hoping for. And what I'm hoping for is based on what God has said, so I can't go wrong. And I understand. And we will see exactly what God has said.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And we'll know it was God when that happens.
Oh, yes.
We won't be able to say, boy, it's that great pastor we've got. Or, man, it's this group, or this or that. All those things, we want to be the best that we can do with whatever we do. But it's still just us.
Exactly.
And without this, the anointing, without the Holy Spirit, it doesn't mean anything.
That's right.
It's just a sign of grass and attendance.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen. All right, well, let's stand.
Thank you, Jesus.
Heavenly Father, thank you.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Bring us here, Lord, this day. We thank you, Father, because we all have heard your calling and we have answered that calling.
In Jesus' mighty name, thank you.
We continue to declare your word, Lord, so that your promises continue to manifest on this earth. We are enlarging the tent of this church, Lord, so that you can continue to grow it according to your glory, Father. You are gathering those that are lost, and you're going to bring them to their land, Lord. You're bringing them to you, Father. You are bringing them to you. We thank you, Father, because everything has been completed through the death of Jesus. You lift us up, Lord. We are your sheep. You are our shepherd. You bring us back to you when we get lost, and you rejoice when we come to you, Lord. Thank you, Father, for being faithful for all the promises that you have given us. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. We give you all the glory and all the praise.
Worthy are you.
Continue to feed us, Lord, so we can continue to go out into this world and and spread your word. Eastern Gate House Prayer Team will be at Kingdom House Prayer on September 20th. We'll be doing 2 hours of worship. Is that correct?
Yeah, we're going to be doing a 24-hour gathering of houses of prayer all over the state of Iowa. They asked us not to join their Kingdom House Prayer situation, but just one like-minded kingdom furthering gathering, just to be in unity. Houses of prayer from all over the state, and individual people are also going to be doing hour sets or 2 hour sets just to do this 24 hour, just to say, we want more of God, we want more of His kingdom in this region. And it's going to be an awesome time. Get to see some brothers and sisters I haven't seen in a while, but they